you, young lady. That's very kind of you.
It's just water.
Give her some money.
Really?
Yes! It's charity. You have things, and she doesn't. You are going to give her some of your things, so she doesn't have a revolution and take all of your things.
Spare change? Any spare change?
The moment charity is mentioned, out comes every layabout.
Here you are.
Thank you. Bless you, kind sir.
Be careful, my lord. Many of the very poor have weapons.
Be gone with you.
No! No, good sirs, this is merely crazy Marie. She lives in the woods and comes to town only to gather what others throw away. She's gentle in every way, sweet and delicate. Butt nuts!
She is harmless, I can tell. Sebastian, Lord Pinkerton, sheathe your swords. You are a good friend to Marie. How lucky she is to have a true friend such as you. I wish I had a true friend.
I'll stay right here!
No, we turn me off!
Very well, Pinkerton. Be well, young lady. Admiration for a true friend in this world. Thank you
that riddles our government. You must go with me.
Cinderella! That is Madame Elf's stepmother.
I will shout to the prince. You have no choice but to listen.
Cinderella! You are in harm's way!
I have a vision of what this kingdom could be.
Cinderella, help me with my heart. Cinderella! Lazy stepdaughter, help me with my...
Why do I care? Why do I try? I'll never be good enough for her. I shall take this book and burn it!
Why not give the book to dear Ellen? If it's quite all right, Jean-Michel, I would love to look at your book about other countries live.
Then here, Ella, take it. I shall go on my own way and live my own life. I'm a loner! You're coming with me, right?
Of course.
Good.
A book? It's been so long since I've owned something. Just me.
Cinderella, get in there and clean the kitchen.
I've just finished it.
Then prepare the dinner.
It's on the stove.
Bed.
Beds are all turned and the bed clothing is all laid out.
Well, where'd you get that book?
Oh, Jean-Michel gave it to me.
So nice that people just give you gifts. Still daddy's little girl. And what's this doing here?
That's my father's coat.
It's rags.
It's all I have to remember him by.
It's rags now. Clean the porch with these rags.
Thank you.
bounty. May I have been premature of your ring on this other announcement?
Sorry. And what's it for?
Oh, nothing. It's complicated. Do you really want me to go into it?
Prince Topher, listen!
What was that?
You must take responsibility for your actions!
Who's that yelling? On the other side of the moat?
The people are being treated unfairly by your government!
He seems upset.
Rabble rouser, ignore him. I have this new law which prevents any. Actually, if you let me have the ring, it would save the trip.
But shouldn't we listen to what he has to say? I mean, people were never upset with Mom and Dad, were they?
Your parents had the good fortune to be royalty in a time of plenty. But since their unfortunate demise, I have done my best to run this country. And done my best to raise you in the finest schools.
Hello, I'm talking here.
You should invite him up for a talk.
Ignore him.
Fine. If you won't listen to me, I'll shout this to the town square.
Shout this to the town square? Perhaps it's time for a distraction.
What kind of distraction?
A royal wedding.
How does that work?
Like a dream, every time.
But who will be getting married?
Well, you!
That's just silly. I don't even know any girls. I went to an all-boys school off in the woods, and then attended an all-male university on an island.
Why would you do that to me?
For this happy day, I'm going to find you a bride. Oh, happy the day.
And how do you suppose you're going to find me a bride?
We shall have a magnificent ball, dancing.
What?
Every eligible young woman who can afford a gown will attend. That is a wonderful selection process right there. If you can't afford a nice dress, you don't have any business marrying a prince. Now, all of the guests will be in masks. You will dance with every girl, and at the stroke of midnight, everyone will remove their masks, and you will have found your bride.
That's fast.
King and queen on the throne. I am there to guide you through all your decisions. It's really a win-win.
But how will any woman ever fall in love with me so quickly?
A valid question, which we'll answer sometime soon. Now, Lord Pinkleton, I want you to tell this to all, a pronouncement, an announcement.
His Royal Highness.
Please don't say my full name.
Rupert, Windermere, Flanders, Carl Alexander.
We didn't name our kid.
Sebastian can take the land from the very poor, it is only a matter of time before he takes it from all of us. Don't you see? For you just can't wait to be served by fate on a silver plate or a tray.
Oh, bloody bottle. All the wishes in the world are poppycock and twaddle. La da 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 da. 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 The prince is giving a ball.
Cinderella, when you finish tightening Delicate Charlotte's corset. We must move on to Gabrielle's hair. It's beginning to look like a Bavarian pretzel. Cinderella! 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 It is the most amusing name. I cracked myself up! She sits by the cinders of the fire. And her name is Ella. Why, Sebastian! What an unexpected delight!
Madame, I have but a moment. I invite you to hang upon my every word.
Invitation accepted.
Tonight's ball shall be in masks. The prince will be in the white mask. What color mask will your daughter Gabrielle be wearing?
Why, pink!
Well, if the daughter is anything like the mother, I think the pink mask and the white mask should meet and fall in love.
Are you implying what I'm inferring?
My daughter is all part of my master plan.
You are brilliant.
And you are perceptive. I shall see you at the ball. Together we shall make this so.
I brought you these flowers, and
you are not welcome here! Out of my house!
Would you perhaps reconsider?
That do not include Mr. Soapbox.
But he means well.
die, I cry. Then I married Cinderella's father for money. He died. I got a house. 7:30. Ball preparation. Double time.
He won't listen to me. He uses his castle to hide from the truth. Him and I talking will never happen. The only thing funnier is you thinking you're going to the ball. Why don't you go ahead and ask the prince when he'll start noticing? Noticing that people are being evicted from their land. That's absurd.
Wait, Jean-Michel, I could go to the prince and he might listen to me. And if I had a ball gown, I think I might look sort of nice.
I am in the royal palace of all places, when I meet the finest prince you've ever seen. And the color on my two stepsisters' faces is a queer sort of sour apple green. I am coy and flirtatious when alone with the prince.
I just knew I would find you.
foolish.
Then be foolish with me. What would you dream of?
I don't know. An invitation to the ball, I suppose.
Right here, an invitation.
What? But it's torn.
Don't wait for everything to be perfect. Just go. Now, what else would you dream of?
A white ball gown, I imagine. A beautiful white ball gown, sewn with pearls and jewels, and a tiara of diamonds.
And on your feet?
Why, the most beautiful grosgrain pumps, I imagine.
No, better. The Venetian glass that your mother oh so loves in her trinkets and baubles. An entire pair of shoes made only with Venetian glass.
Why, I'd be the envy of all. But how would I get to the ball?
Well, this pumpkin over here?
Yes.
Or a raccoon as a driver?
Oh, Marie, you really are crazy. Why, in order to do something like that, you'd have to be my fairy godmother.
Marie, but you're a crazy woman. What are you doing in this beautiful gown?
You'd be surprised how many beautiful gowns have crazy women in them.
Godmother?
But of course not, child. Actually, I'm a frequency fairy godmother. But you're the only one who has given me charity, generosity, and kindness. And now I must make all the dreams we joked about come true.
But it's so improbable, implausible.
Pumpkin and a
Age before beauty! You first
have a lovely speaking voice. Have you ever considered reciting poetry?
What? Say it! What? Do it! The anticipation is killing me. Do the ritual! Why do you say that?
No reason. I just really like your speaking voice and think you would sound wonderful reciting a poem. I also like that feather in your hair. It's a lovely color for you.
Why are you doing this to me?
What is this bewitchery you practice?
It's just kindness.
Kindness?
Oh yes, kindness is practicing all the great points now. Ridicule isn't done anywhere anymore. It's all kindness now, even in the French courts.
Condiments?
Kindness, you know, compassion.
Who are you, you strange woman?
I don't know who she is, but she is very, very wealthy indeed. And did you see her feet? She was made entirely of Venetian glass. My resentment is all-consuming.
Kindness, you must all try it.
No, I don't think so.
Not I.
I will be the first.
I'll be the first. Kindness. Isn't it wonderful to have such a pleasant lady in our court?
Thank you. And it is an honor to be at this wonderful party you are throwing.
Oh! It's like every time we speak, a part of me dies!
This ballroom is filled as a blowout waste from Nyla's.
You're right, they are quite extraordinary.
I just saw the vanilla cake at the buffet.
I love vanilla cake. Thank you for your faith.
This court is filled with warmth and happiness.
It's just like a cluster of rain.
I admire how you changed everything around me, and yet I feel so comfortable with you. I feel as if I have been cheated.
Thank you.
found you.